bring a dog in here? He is a service dog.
I love all animals, but dogs are special.
Thanks. Yeah, Hoof can come in.
Welcome. I thought today might be some new spirits to my life.
This is Hank and Luna and Zodiac, and this is Hoover. He belongs with Zodiac.
Say hi, Hoover.
Hello, buddy. Can I give him a treat?
Oh, yeah, he's always hungry.
You do tricks?
I mean, kinda, if he feels like it. He's pretty lazy. Sit. Oh, yeah, I know, bud. Do it for the food.
He's smart. That's better than obedience.
I agree. He saved me on more than one occasion.
Good boy. I see why you call him Hoover. And I like your name, Zodiac. How'd you get it?
Oh, we used to give each other code names when we went on missions.
I was Saturn, and Hank was Jupiter.
And when I was little, I was like super into astrology. I'm an Aquarius, so they called me Zodiac.
I'm an Aquarius as well.
And when I was in boarding school, all the guys thought I was named after the serial killer. And I just leaned into it, so they'd stay away.
These are the friends that I was telling you about. The ones I solved mysteries with.
I realized, I was there when you saved the movie theater.
Yeah, they thought it was haunted by a vampire, but it was really just Reese Lanchester trying to lower property values so he could build a department store.
It's an honor to have local heroes in the shop.
I'm Betty Roswell.
Thanks for having us.
Danny's a friend of mine, so you all get the friends and family discount today.
Jeez, thanks, Mrs. Roswell!
We're actually here to ask you about the Foggy Bluff Monster.
Oh?
You have all those books you saw, and we're trying to learn more about it.
Have you ever seen the Foggy Bluffs Monster?
It hasn't been seen in a long time.
So you haven't?
I didn't say that. I just saw it a long time ago.
I think I saw it once. What do you think it is?
Well, how much do you know about it?
It's just an urban legend. It's an owl seen by hippies on hallucinogens.
Well, my friend, I've seen it. And I was stone cold sober. It's mostly a way to make money now. T-shirts and stuff. But Foggy Bluffs has always been plagued by stories of monsters. And something it all comes back to. The Beast.
We spent a lot of time in graveyards and forests, and we never saw anything like the Beast.
That's an easy excuse. This place isn't haunted. It's kind of weird, but it's not haunted.
Depending on how you define haunted.
I don't really remember the story.
It fell out of fashion around when you all must have been born. Wait 1 minute, let me find the VHS.
I know she's kooky, but she's really smart.
Watch this. In the small town of Foggy Bluffs, New York, not much was said to happen. But in between the rolling mists and scenic forests lurks a secret few admit to believe in. One dim October night, a young married couple was driving along the banks of the Little Green River. To protect their identities, let's call them Barry and Beth Frank. The newlyweds were returning home from their honeymoon. Late at night, the famous fog filled the roads. Around 11:23 p.m., Barry Frank reported seeing something in his rearview mirror.
I thought it must have been a deer. I ignored it. You see deer all the time out near the river.
Then a large shape zoomed by back on the passenger side. She was frightened. But the couple simply wanted to return home. Suddenly, about 100 feet in front of the car, two giant red eyes shone out at them like fiery orbs. They must have been 10 feet off the ground at least. Slamming the brakes, the couple faced what would become known in the years to come as the Foggy Bluffs Monster. It stared at us. It definitely stared. You could feel it thinking, taking us in.
I have never been more frightened. At first, I thought it was an owl. I told myself the fog was throwing off my depth perception, but no owl was that big.
You could see his body, just a bit. It was dark, but we had our headlights on.
An amateur sketch artist, Barry Frank, produced this impression of the beast. After a harrowing standoff, the beast seemed to pulse its eyes at them.
Next thing we know, it's morning. We're driving down the road, a couple miles south of where we were. No fog, no monster. We didn't know what to do, so we went home.
I'd have thought I dreamed the whole thing if it weren't for
Beth, my wife,
saying that she saw it too. That and the scorch mark on the side of the car where it flew past us.
That night was the first of the dreams. Originally, they were just images. But soon I began to remember more and more about what happened in blurry ways.
I didn't remember until she told me about her dreams. I didn't have the dreams. I never really remembered my dreams, but she does.
We were abducted, taken somewhere by the monster, somewhere where I felt lighter. Sometimes
Barry, my husband,
was with me. Sometimes I turned my head and he wasn't. I remember experiments. I remember there being more than one. I remember them showing me things, visions from the future.
The Franks reported their experience to local police. And other than a few reports in the local papers, relatively little occurred. What is the Foggy Bluffs monster?
An alien?
A demon?
A ghost?
Although nowadays you can find its visage printed on many a t-shirt or tourist trap souvenir lunchbox, the residents of Foggy Bluffs, New York, know that something dangerous lurks in the woods by the river.
Legend?
Whatever you call it, there is a monster that only comes out of those woods once every several years. Wandering the woods at night, you might see those big red eyes like I did.
What happened when you saw it?
It was just a passing look. It didn't stick around for long. Not much to tell other than I saw it.
I think maybe the Foggy Bluffs monster is one of the aliens that abducted me.
You've been abducted?
You remember the DuMaurier kidnapping a few years ago?
Yes, it was the only thing in the Gazette for a year.
Yeah, that was me, but I wasn't kidnapped, I was abducted.
What happened?
They wiped my memories of most of it, but not all of it. I remember some experiments. They used some sort of computer that let me speak to Hoover. Hoover was the one who asked to get us out. He got us out, I think. They opened the metal doors, and I couldn't move or see, but I heard the sound, and then Hoover pulled us out. I don't always remember everything, but I usually remember red eyes.
That's what people always remember the most. The sharp red lights watching them. Did it feel like you were being analyzed?
I don't remember.
I remember feeling like I was being measured, judged for something.
Do you have any books about it?
The best one is Creature in the Fog. Anything else is just a rip off of this one. It comes with a DVD of the documentary, too.
I'll buy it.
I haven't seen it since, have you? I can feel it watching me sometimes, but it doesn't reveal itself.
Me too.
One day, they will find us again. Arm yourself, know what you can, and be ready. Those aliens, that monster, whether they're the same or not, they're guarding something in those woods. There are things they don't want us to see.
So, I think this is a good start on research, but I think we should try to get our hands on some official case files for some perspective.
All right. What next?
Maybe we should go for a drive down to the bluffs.
Great idea, Hank. We can look for the monster.
Be careful. Take a dog with you. There's power in numbers.
Let's just hang out for a bit before we go monster hunting. Make sure we know what we're getting into.
I agree. We can't just go barging headfirst into danger.
Gotta look for clues.
Why don't you kids take a look around? You never know what you'll find in this shabby treasure trove.
How are you liking those cards here? Are they teaching you?
They're so beautiful. I carry them with me everywhere now.
I thought you'd like them.
You're terror? I thought you were a skeptic.
We all contain multitudes, my dear. Reality is a kaleidoscope.
Tarot aren't magic, though. They just tell you what you are already thinking about, but might not be ready to admit.
So how do they tell the future?
They don't, but they can be comforting for making decisions, for self-reflecting.
Will you read it for me sometime?
Oh, I'm not that good yet. I still use a guidebook.
Okay, so does it have to be now?
Everything in this time. That's the head you're telling me about?
I don't know what you're talking about, Betty.
I like the flowers. You should try it on, Hank.
I don't know, man. It's really not my style.
I don't know. I think you look nice in flowers.
I don't know. It's just not very manly, you know?
Who cares about manly?
Here, try this scarf.
You look cool. Nice and soft.
Soft?
It's a good thing.
You should
okay.
Get
it. Oh, I don't know what I'd wear it with.
With this? This outfit?
I don't know. I don't think I'm going to buy anything today.
Fine. I'll buy it for you.
It's a gift. A welcome back gift.
Welcome back me.
That's really nice. You don't have to do that.
I just think you should have it.
Hey, Hank. What do you think of my necklace?
Oh, it's nice. Let's grab a pizza before we head out. I'm starving.
Come back anytime. Will that be all?
Hey, Mom. Yeah, I'm fine. No practice. Work was fine. Just wanted to tell you that I'm not gonna be home for dinner tonight. Me and Dan. Yeah, sorta. Well, actually, Luna is gonna be there too. No, just us. Okay, gotta go. Love you, Mom.
Over. But don't worry, Danny got your favorite. An entire stick of pepperoni. Say thank you.
You're welcome, Hoover.
It's almost his dinner time.
Just, wait for dinner?
It's so weird how this town, it's like everything is almost the same, but not at all. Like, it's an oil painting and I remember a cartoon.
It's just a normal town. You'll get bored of it soon.
Everything okay with your mom, Hank?
Yeah, let's go!
Sweet!
What are you looking at?
Oh, it was just, no, nothing. It's fine. I'm okay. It's okay.
Okay, I parked over here. Hoover! That was Mr. Dahl, right?
Huh?
Hey, I'm Henson, dude. Mr. Dahl? Is that you? You real?
No, it wouldn't be.
Mr. Dahl, is this your dog?
It is a dog.
Mr. Dahl, I want to see what you look like.
You've seen me.
The real you. I know you look different.
What could you mean?
When I'm not looking, when you're looking at me, when your eyes look red.
Will you come with me?
Where will we go?
Nowhere difficult, but very far away.
And you'll tell me who you are?
Yes.
And will you bring me back here?
Yes.
Can I tell my friends goodbye?
You don't want them to be jealous of you, do you? You're a very special boy. Only you get to come with me.
How long will we be gone?
We don't have time.
Can the dog come too?
Yes. Come here, Walter.
I want to say goodbye to my friends.